It's your first year on the tenure track. Learn five things you can do to make it a great one right now. Hey everybody, I'm Lee Hall from teachingacademia.com, and I'm all about giving you the tools you need to navigate academia and make your best impact. In this series, we're talking about your first year on the tenure track, and in this video, I'm going to share with you five things that you need to know that are going to help you get off to a great start in your first year. So let's dive in. All right, number one, get your office organized, okay? Don't throw a bunch of boxes and books and whatever into your office and think, I'll get to that later, because you're gonna get really busy and later is always going to be a little further down the road. So if you can, if you're in town early, see if you can get permission to get into your office. You might not be able to, but if you can, get in a little early. It'll give you some time to set up, get everything pretty well organized the way that you want it, so that when the semester starts, you can hit the ground running. All right, number two, establish a schedule, a routine very early on in the academic year. Now, you're not necessarily gonna know what the best schedule and routine is because you're starting your first year. You know, you're in a new position, you're in a new place, and you're not really going to be sure of how well any schedule that you put together flows. But make sure that you've got, you know, time in, you know, to get your teaching done, you know, block out when you teach your classes, make sure you've got time blocked out to get your research done and your writing done, that sort of a thing, and then tweak it from there as it makes sense. And so it might make sense to come up with a schedule, sort of run it through that first semester, and then revise it to something that's going to work a little bit better for the second semester. But My main point here is, even though you can come up with a schedule and it might not end up working super well for you, having one will get you started and moving in the right direction. It will get you thinking about your routines. It will get you thinking about how you are designing your days so that it supports you getting the work done that you need to get done. And tweaking it along the way to reflect the realities of your situation is always incredibly easy. All right, so number three, find a mentor. Now, you might have an official mentor program as part of your, you know, university, your college department, whatever, and that might plug you in right away and help you get connected right away, and that's really great. So if you do have that option, then by all means, take advantage of it. Now, if you don't have that option, seek out pretty early on. I would seek out ideally a full professor, but definitely at least an associate professor to be your official mentor who can help you understand the politics of, you know, the department that you're in, can help you understand the tenure and promotion process, can help you with any questions you might have about, you know, if you need IRB approvals, if you have questions about your courses, just somebody who can, if they don't have the answer, they know who does. All right. And that's what you're looking for. Now, obviously you don't need just one mentor. You want to, you know, you want other people that are going to be able to support you in different ways, and you will find those people along the way, but you do want to establish a really great connection early on with somebody who is really taking on this official mentoring role. All right. So this leads me to number four, learn the tenure expectations. You might, I'm sure when you interviewed, you probably got, you know, a whiff of this. Somebody might have explained it to you, a dean, a department chair, another faculty member. You might have talked about it a little bit. But now is the time to make sure you really understand those expectations. So this is a really good thing to talk to your mentor about, or a department chair about, right? Whoever is appropriate in your context. And it, you know, this also gets back to establishing a schedule, right? You want to make sure you understand those tenure expectations and then design a schedule that is going to allow you to not just meet, I like to say meet and exceed the expectations, because I like people to go into tenure feeling really, really confident knowing they've exceeded the expectations. That's just me. But learn those tenure expectations, design a schedule, even consider designing that schedule in conjunction with your mentor or having your mentor give you feedback on it, so that, you know, you're doing what you need to do so that you're set up on this really nice trajectory right from the get-go in that first semester. And then finally, Set yourself some writing and teaching goals, okay? Now, what these goals look like and where you might be heaviest on them, right? If you have more writing or more teaching goals, that's gonna depend on your institution, on the nature of your job, and your tenure expectations. So once you understand those tenure expectations, come up with something, you know, to help you improve as a writer, as a teacher. So for a writing goal, I might say by the end of the first semester, this is what I want to have done, right? Maybe I want a publication out the door to a particular journal, okay? Or maybe I want to look at my, you know, publication goals for the entire year and set some benchmarks for that, all right? For my teaching goals, I might think of something that I know I professionally need to work on and develop in myself as a teacher. And then I might identify some books to help me with that, or go to a conference, or, you know, some on-campus events that they might have, or workshops that would align and support your teaching goals, okay? So having writing goals, you want that so that you're staying on track with getting your publications. But having teaching goals doesn't mean that you're a bad teacher, right? We're all always working to improve our teaching. So if you can identify some ways that you are, you know, working on that, that's honestly gonna help you with tenure, because by the time you get to the point where you have to turn in your document for tenure and promotion, you will be able to talk about the ways you have developed as an educator over that 5 to 6 year period as an assistant professor. So what are some other things that you think are important to set up on this first year? Head on down to the comments and let me know.